I wanted to talk today about why I buy my MacBooks used. There are tons of reasons to buy computers used. This video, I'm going to be talking about MacBooks specifically, but you can sort of stretch this out to all computers and almost all tech. I have a few differing opinions about phones because people will take their phones into kind of gross places and do gross things with them, so I try to avoid that. But on the other side of that, computers are normally stationary, and if they are laptops, you can clean it down, and they don't normally do those similar things. So I'm going to talk about why I buy my MacBooks used, specifically the one that I'm using at the moment, and then the one that my wife uses. And I've bought probably 35 MacBooks in the past to buy at a cheaper price and sell at a profit. So I'm going to go over all those things, what I'm looking for. So the main reason that I'm purchasing MacBooks used is because it's way cheaper. I mean, regardless of the fact that you don't have to pay taxes on like a $2,500 computer, which at 7-8% is almost $200 in some cases, that's a ton of money to save. It's also the fact that you're getting it at a discount. So no matter how brand new the laptop is, it's always going to be sold at some type of a discount. So if it's a 20, let's see, the year's 2021, if you were to buy a 2020 MacBook, it would cost significantly less than buying it new from Apple, irregardless of the taxes that you get to save. And also, people locally have much more of an ability to sort of like waver on their price. If I go to Apple and I say, I like the laptop, I think it's a good deal, but I would do $2,400 instead of $2,800. I have cash and I can meet you right now. They would say, sir, it's $2,800. That's it. We have options for $2,400, but this one's $2,800. So people locally have a lot more willingness to budge on price and negotiate a little bit so we can work on a deal, making sure that both parties are happy. And obviously, I've done that to an extreme extent. The laptop right here is a 2018 MacBook Pro that I purchased back almost a year ago now, that I purchased to edit videos on, which has turned maybe, I've talked about this before, but it's made me more money than it cost me in the first place. But at the time, it was only $1,200 for me to buy that MacBook Pro. And at the time, it was worth like $1,400 or $1,500 or $1,600 used elsewhere. So that's why I ended up buying it. I was going to end up flipping it, but I knew that I was editing videos for that guy, and it ended up working out a lot better for me to just use that laptop instead of the other laptop that I was using. So I ended up keeping it as more of like a business decision. But I do know that this thing still maintains its value. It might be only worth $1,200 now, but it still maintains its value. The next part would be sort of leaning into that maintains its value. When you purchase something used, the amount that it can decrease is significantly less. So if you purchase a laptop for $2,000 that was originally $3,000, it's already lost $1,000. The likelihood that it loses another $1,000 in a year or 2 years' time is probably pretty minimal. Laptops, especially MacBooks, hold their value exceptionally well. I've definitely noticed that through all the MacBooks that I've purchased, is that you can buy a MacBook 1 year and then 2 or 3 years later, sell that same MacBook and at sometimes even a profit compared to what you purchased it at. So I've noticed that a lot with the MacBooks that I've purchased, the MacBooks that I've used in the past. I used to buy and sell a lot of laptops just to make a few $100 on each one. That's what I like to do. I still do it sometimes, just not that as often as I used to. But I really like the idea that I can purchase something in 2021 that's like a 2018, so it's 3 years old and it's lost at this point about $1,200 in terms of this laptop. And over the next year or 2 or 3 years, it won't lose an additional $1,200. It might lose 30% of its value in the next 3 years, but compared to the loss that you would have if you were to purchase it new, it's significantly less. Now, obviously there are some downsides to buying used. Buying used, it's used, so you don't know exactly how somebody has treated that laptop. You expect them to treat it well, but there's always a chance that you purchase it from somebody who's a smoker, somebody who doesn't take care of their things, so on and so forth. So I obviously, you sort of manage those risks a little bit. Refurbish is an option. I still don't love going refurbished because, again, if you buy a $2,000 laptop refurbished, there's massive taxes that you have to pay. And also on top of that, it's still far more expensive than what you would purchase it on eBay or if you were to find it on Facebook Marketplace. I prefer on Facebook Marketplace because it's more of a human-to-human interaction. People are way less likely to lie right to your face than they are over messages on eBay. So I like meeting the person in person and then saying, hey, like, how did you use this laptop? What did you use it for? Why are you selling it? You ask them all these things and they're going to tell you the truth. It's really hard for people to lie to your face because I think humans naturally are pretty decent people. Maybe I'm overestimating people, and I've definitely bought some duds on laptops, but generally speaking, I think that the money that I've saved from buying used far outweighs any potential money that I could have lost had I purchased that thing new and if it was broken. On top of that, you can often get some type of deal situation going on with the computer or anything else used. I purchase a lot of desktop computers used, and people will often throw in keyboards, monitors, mice, cases with their MacBook Pros. I've gotten like external trackpads, external mice. I've even had external DVD recorders and readers and writers, because people, when they're selling their laptops, are normally done with that laptop and they no longer want it. So they'll just give you everything that came with it. I found that that's pretty cool. I know I've done that before. I've sold computers and I'll just throw in a keyboard if the guy wants it because he wanted the keyboard. I don't really care. I'm not gonna charge him for it. So I know that a lot of people have done that with me, where they throw in a case. The cases are a little bit gross because you don't really know what they've been doing with it and where that's been at. I like the free mice that I've gotten, the free DVD recorders, and then obviously the external trackpads and external keyboards. I've gotten those as well. So you can get a number of range of things just from buying something used, because people, again, I think are generally pretty nice and pretty good, and they often just give you things because they just want to get rid of it. On top of that, you can also get far more for your money. So not only are you saving money, but you're also getting better performance. Obviously, if I spend $2,000 of used for used computer parts, I'll get a way better computer than had I spent $2,000 of new computer parts. But that's worth it to me. The gain in performance is sometimes 30, 40, 50, 60, 70%. It's pretty massive in terms of what you're talking about, how much extra money you can save, and then how much more performance you can get for even less money in some cases. I know my friend who buys and sells computers often, his computer that he owns right now was a 100% free. He's been paid probably thousands of dollars to actually have the computer, because he's been buying and selling parts and pulling pieces from other desktop computers that he wanted, putting it in his computer and swapping things like that. So I go more extreme on the buying and selling of MacBooks and computers, but I do think you can get a lot of great value from just buying used. I know I buy lots of my stuff used. Anything that's a tech product except for my phone, I'll buy used. And the reason is because you can just get more for your money. The reason, again, with the phone is there were many factors where I purchased it new. I've talked about it before, but I needed the phone for work. And then I also needed something that I could get that day. And used phones, it just was hard to find locally. I don't really love buying used phones locally because they could not be paid off all the way. They could have certain things that people have done with them. They could be iCloud locked. You just don't really know. And I don't know that much about phones. I think it's not worth the risk to me for a phone. But for a laptop, there are definitely risks, like having an iCloud lock laptop, so on and so forth. But the chances of that happening compared to a phone is pretty much zero. And also what I've noticed is that people can't make payment plans on their laptops the same way they can do with phones. They might throw it on a credit card, but that credit card company isn't going to come after the laptop. They're just going to come after the person's income. So that's obviously another great reason, is that you're sort of protected if the person hasn't paid the laptop off. So that's obviously another great reason to buy used. And I also just think it's kind of fun. I'm somebody who likes to buy something used at a discounted price and then sell it for a more expensive price. So I like doing that. I do it with laptops, I do it with computers. It's a good way to make some extra money. It's not thousands of dollars every single year, but if you work really hard at it, you can make a few extra spending bucks to then buy some Chipotle or something. I don't know, maybe a better computer. Maybe you could upgrade your personal computer with the profits that you made from buying and reselling. And another reason would be that you are forced to buy the MacBook with cash or the computer with cash. Lots of people buy everything on credit cards, or most things on payment plans / credit cards. And I think it's really important for people to get into the mindset of not doing that. And when you buy used, nobody has ever paid me with a credit card, because if they try to pay me with a credit card, I'd say, no, thank you. I want cash. And so people will have to pay with cash. So you will have to in turn pay with cash. I think it's very good. That way you feel how much money that is. You feel the sting of buying that laptop or that computer, whatever it may be. And you sort of maybe make a better decision because this is a little bit more expensive than I thought it was. You decide to go maybe a little bit cheaper, or you go a different route. So those are all my things I'm thinking about whenever I'm purchasing a used MacBook Pro. I haven't done it in a long time. I probably won't do it for a long time because this MacBook that I'm using is great. But I do think that these things are all important to think about because they go further than just computers. Yes, MacBooks, that's the title of this video. But also you could think about this in terms of a desktop or a monitor or a nightstand or a bed. Not a bed. I probably wouldn't buy a bed used, but what do beds sit on? Bed frames, things like that. Tables, chairs, things like this that you can buy at a significantly discounted price, sometimes 90% off of what you would purchase that same exact thing in the store. So that's how I like doing it. I think it could save people a lot of money. And the more money you can save, the more money you can invest for your future. I think that that's definitely worth it. So I like doing that. I'm sure some people don't want to do that or don't love doing it. But I think all of the other things laid out in this video as to why you should purchase used will hopefully push some people to buying used. I'm not going to tell you which laptop to buy. Please don't ask me. Well, should I get a 2015 i7? Yada, yada, yada. I'm not going to answer those questions. Just get a laptop, do your research on it, and make sure it's something that you need. And also consider how old the laptop is. 2015s are 6 years old at this point. I don't really want to talk about specs. Just the general ideas, how you could save a bunch of money when purchasing a MacBook. Thank you for watching the video. I will see you tomorrow. This is 30 days thing is kind of killing me. So I'm not sure if I'm going to keep doing it because it's absolutely exhausting and I'm kind of miserable. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.